Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Boardman Performing Arts Center. Please take a moment to locate the exit that is closest to you to be used in the event of emergency. We ask that you turn off or silence your cell phones or other electronic devices, and video recording and flash photography is prohibited. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Miss Ferretti, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-C-Y-G-Y. Syzygy.
We have a winner!
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!
Thank you. sorry there are no photos at the B. Now, it seems there are a few spellers who haven't checked in with us, so if I call your name, please book these steps and meet me over at the desk. I'm missing a Jonathan DeRabio, Patrick Kale, Phil Rorsch, Daniel Menser, and Nina Hudock. I also need to speak with a Miss Olive Ostrovsky.
Oh, I'm Olive.
Miss Ostrovsky, it seems we haven't received your entrance fee.
Entrance fee?
Did the school not tell you about the entrance fee? Is your mom here, maybe? Or your dad?
Well, my mom's not here right now. My dad's coming in later from work.
Who brought you to the bee, dear?
The bus!
Okay, we'll talk about the entrance fee later.
Hey, Marcy, don't be nervous. Just watch what I do.
Don't worry. I'm not nervous.
Hey, have you ever been in an underground gymnasium before?
I've never been in a gymnasium before.
So what school do you...
Shut up!
Ladies and gentlemen, the children you see on stage are here because of their extraordinary ability and love of language, but...
Yeah, already a winner.
But only one of them can go on to compete in the National Spelling Bee. And this year, in honor of our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrists, are offering today's winner a $200 savings bond toward his or her future educations.
Ooh.
But remember, to get here, each child had to win or place in their own district B, so each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hello, I'm Ronalisa Peretti, and I'm pleased to be back for my ninth year as your host. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Spriggs, has fallen ill. So please, join me in welcoming back Vice Principal Douglas Ponch from the Hemingway Vespasas Junior High. Vice Principal Ponch has returned to us after a five-year hiatus, so thank you, Douglas, for stepping in on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona. And as I like to say, as to the incident 5 years ago, I think I'm in a much better place now. It's a wonder what a diet came from.
Wonderful!
I'd like to add here, Miss Brady is not only one of the top realtors in our county, she's also a former spelling champion herself.
Third annual?
Syzygy.
Syzygy. When the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
Wonderful. Don't forget how I have the Pledge of Allegiance led by our conflict counselor, whose name I know. His name is Mitch Mahoney.
Mr. Mahoney is doing his community service work with us here today.
Stop.
And now, without further ado, let the spelling begin with Ms. Schwartz.
Ms. Logan Schwartz in Grubinger is the head of the Gay Straight Alliance at her elementary school.
Strabismus.
Strabismus. May I please have a definition of that word?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision due to a muscular imbalance.
And use in a sentence, please.
Billy, on the courtyard, proclaimed that he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said, whereupon the bullies beat him harder.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way to see the word before she speaks it out loud.
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coneybear.
Mr. Coneybear was second runner-up in the Putnam Basin District.
Brooke, will you tell Leaf he has a phone call?
Leaf. Phone. Oh, well, thanks, I got it. Hi, hello, Leaf speaking. You're kidding! I'm gonna represent the basin in the beat. Oh, wow, I can't believe it! Mom, Dad, Marigold, Brooke, Pinecone, Landscape, Raisin, Paula! You're not gonna believe this!
What's up, Leaf?
I made the county finals for the spelling bee!
Oh, sweetheart, no. You came in third, honey.
Oh, I know. But they just called and said the person who came in first has to go to their bat mitzvah. And the person who came in second has to attend the bat mitzvah. So they want me to do it.
I realize all the other kids would have won their district B.
Yeah, but...
Capybara.
What?
Your word is capybara.
Is that a word?
That's a word, yes.
No way! What's it mean?
It means a South American tailless, largely aquatic rodent that can grow up to about 4.5 feet in length.
Awesome! What else did I ask?
You can ask the language of origin or have it used in a sentence.
Oh. Can you use it in a sentence?
Of course. Don't look now, Doctor, but I believe the tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent swimming next to you might be a capybara.
Wow. That didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word, Mr. Coneybear?
No, but it was fun being here. Hi, guys! My whole family's here, which is really C-A-P-Y-B-A-R-A! Capybara?
That is correct.
It is?
Yes.
Wow. I can't believe it. It's unbelievable. I just said the first letters that came to mind, and that Y was really...
Misel Strofsky came in second in her school's Halloween contest.
I was roadkill.
Your word is boanthropy.
Boanthropy. May I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, excuse me, sir. Can you please not sit in that seat? I saved the chair for my dad in the fourth row on the aisle, and it may take him a
Whenever Jack gets depressed about living in a dystopia, he calls his family in Chicago.
Dystopia. D-Y-S-T-O-P-I-A. Dystopia.
That is correct.
Mr. Warsh was once detained at the airport for trying to smuggle a small rodent home from Argentina.
Your word is punxsutawney.
Punxsutawney? Definition, please.
A city in Pennsylvania.
Okay. Can you say a sentence?
Yesterday was the Groundhog Day celebration in Punxsutawney.
Punxsutawney. P U. X. A T O N Y. Punxsutawney.
Mr. Barfi has a rare mucous membrane disorder.
The word is lugubrious.
Yes, of course. Lugubrious, meaning extremely sad or droopy.
More or less, yes.
A topic I am all too familiar with. One moment, please.
Okay, so now watch this technique. He calls it the magic foot, and he's the only one I've ever seen use it. He spells the word out on the floor so we can get a visual, and then he speaks it out loud. Incredible!
Lugubrious! L-U-G-U-B-R-I-O-U-S! Lugubrious!
That is correct.
I know!
Miss Kudok.
Miss Kudok likes to play dress up.
Your word is epicolix.
May I have the definition?
An involucre resembling a plant stem, but consisting of a whorl of bracts that is exterior to calyx, or results from the union of the sepal appendages.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Look at that epicolix.
Epicolix. A.
I get a definition?
One of the 50 states of the United States.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Please, please, never make me go back to Florida.
F-L-O-R-I-D-A.
Florida. That is correct. Miss Park.
Miss Park is new to our county, having placed 9th in nationals last year as a representative of Virginia.
Beautiful country.
Your word is phylactery.
Phylactery. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Thank you. May I have a definition, please?
One of two small square leather boxes placed on the forearm or forehead of Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have it in a sentence, please?
Billy, put down the phylactery. We're Episcopalian.
Thank you. Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y, phylactery.
That is correct.
Miss Park, slam dunk.
Hey, Marcy, you were at Nationals. Remember me?
I only remember the top 10.
Charlito, Chip Tolentino is a little bit with the power screwball.
Throw it faster!
Your word is umphaloskepsis.
What? Didn't the guy who's wanted dead in New Mexico just get Florida?
Yes, and you got umphaloskepsis.
But are those even rated at the same level of difficulty?
They're both level one words, yes.
Omphaloskepsis. Could that also be pronounced omphaloskepsis?
It can, it would be wrong.
Omphaloskepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Omphaloskepsis.
That's correct.
He rhymes and nails it. That's what it means to be a champion.
Mr. Colley.
Mr. Colley got an A on his book report. Just because I'm hairy doesn't mean I'm not happy.
Your word is cow.
You can't be serious! Come on!
There's a speller, a microphone, cow.
Can I have the definition? Can you use it in a sentence?
No.
Cow. C-O-W.
That was so moronic.
I can cry. I want more than play.
It's your funny bag.
I felt super sonic.
Sure.
That is why.
Cheers.
word is cystitis.
Cystitis. May I please have the definition of that word?
An inflammation of the urinary bladder.
And use in a sentence, please.
Sally's mother told her it was her cystitis that made her special.
Cystitis. I think I studied this one with my dad.
Segway.
S-E-G-U-P.
Good. Siphon.
S-I-P-H-O-N.
Good. Cystitis.
S.
No. Think.
C.
Good.
I.
No! Logan, are you concentrating?
Yes.
Maybe it's time for a break.
Dan! We're in the middle of a word here! You know she can't spell when her blood sugar's low. We have to build up her stamina. The bee could last up to 3 hours. Don't you talk to me about stamina, Carl. Daddy conference. Now!
No, Dad, let me get this
word
first.
Spell it, Logan.
Cystitis. C-Y-T-I-T-I-S. Cystitis.
That is correct. Mr. Cardio.
Mr. Hollabaugh makes his own clothes.
A coochie.
A what?
Your word is a coochie.
Had a spelling bee? What's it mean?
A South American rodent resembling an agouti.
It's funny how I keep getting South American rodents.
Hilarious.
Look, honestly, I've never heard this word before, and I have no idea how to spell it.
Would you like to forfeit your turn?
Why don't you just give it your best shot, Mr. Cody Bear?
I'm not that smart. My siblings have been telling me that for years. That I'm not smart. We're schooled at home, they see it's bright, it breaks my heart. Not that smart. Hey, you know what? Hey, you know what? Guess what? Guess what? Hey, you know what? I have a gentle personality, which to all agree is an anthem out of my more aggressive family. Everyone keeps swatting.
Don't hit!
Everyone keeps yelling.
Don't hit!
How could a flea such as me think he'd be good at spelling? How? I don't know. I like my hair. Really, it is pleasant to the touch. I toss my hair a bit too much. It doesn't move, it simply sits. I make a part, I'm not that smart. Da 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 da.
Right,
I didn't cheat.
Spencer.
Miss Spencer, what the bet up until last week? Going strong, Miss Spencer.
The word is crapon.
Can you give me a definition, please?
An edible bullfrog from South or Central America.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Despite the absence of any actual frog meat, Mary's lasagna tasted like crapon.
Crapod. C-R-U-P-O-D.
Champion. Shoulders back, chin up, hair away from your face. Very good. This is a hard age for girls.
I fell.
And boys, with this difference, ask any child in the spelling bee if they expect to win. Boys and girls are trained to respond differently. The correct response for boys is...
I'm taking it off! You're all going down!
And the correct response for girls is...
Honestly, I think there's a good chance I would do okay. I mean, it's unlike I win the whole thing, though. I'm a good speller, but I'm not a truly great speller. And although I've trained hard, there is so much luck involved.
Although in my experience, sometimes the girls are thinking...
I'm taking it all! You're all going down, suckers!
And sometimes the boys are thinking...
I don't know. Am I really good enough to win the bee?
And I'm thinking, does flagellate have one L or two? Also, if you take the W in answer, the H in ghost, the extra A in artwork, and the T in listen, you could keep saying... What?
Dress your sister?
Oh yeah, that's Marigold.
Mr. Girobio.
Mr. Girobio got 10 stitches on his head from falling from the height of his ego.
The word is hornswoggle.
Can I get a definition?
To lie or deceive or cheat by various means.
Sentence?
Although an avid follower of Jesus, Judas was known to do a little hornswoggle every once in a while.
Hornswoggle. H-O-R-S-W-A-G-G-L-E. Hornswoggle.
Not the disciple.
Unfortunate.
barfing made it to finals last year before having to be eliminated for health-related reasons.
Run their peanuts in the brownies! They said there weren't gonna be no peanuts in the brownies!
We're glad to see him back and spelling so well.
The word is Hassenpfeffer.
I have a question. Hassenpfeffer! Meaning a highly seasoned rabbit stew often served with sour cream?
Rabbit stew, that's correct.
My old friend, one moment, please.
He's coming for the foot.
Exception to the Q U rule. From the Turkish. Q-A-I-M-A-Q-A-M Kamakam.
That's remarkable.
And correct.
Miss Park is all business.
No, I'm not.
Mr. Tolentino.
Marigold. Marigold Coney Bear.
Yeah.
That's a lovely dress you have on, Marigold. I love you, Marigold. Kit! Sorry, is it my turn to spell?
Yes.
A rare break in concentration for Mr. Tolentino.
Could you maybe skip me now and ask me two in a row later?
Why would you want to do that?
I'd rather not say.
You can either skip your turn now and forfeit, or you could spell the word.
I'll take my turn now.
Another excellent decision by the incumbent.
Excuse me.
Oh, he must be really excited to spell right now.
Mr. Tolentino, your word is tit-up.
What?
Tit-up.
Can I have the definition, please?
It means restless movement or lively behavior. It refers to the sound of horses' hooves. Tit up, tit up, tit up.
Tit up. T I T U. Oh, wait! Two T's. You heard both, right? Backing up. T I T T U P. Tit up.
Is incorrect. The correct spelling is T-I-T-T-U-P.
But that's exactly what I said.
Well, first you said T-I-T-U...
No, I was just making sure you were both keys. I can't get on a word I spelled right.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequence is a letter already spoken, hanging on the chain.
I can't get on a word I spelled right.
Cheer them up when they lose. I want to tell them disappointment doesn't last forever. But from what I've seen, disappointment lasts like hell. I want to tell them words don't matter. But from what I've seen, words can get you killed. You know, I just want to, like, beat them up a little. Show them that pain has degree. And that this, this is nothing. This is nothing, you little freaks! But that would violate my parole. So I do what I can. Give him a hug. And a juice box. I'm here to give comfort. Let's go, kid!
Miss Brady, can I please have one more time?
Oh, please!
Rightful
ease in a sentence?
No funk, no justice.
Justice. J-U-S-T-I-C-E. Justice.
That is correct. Mr. Pele.
Mr. Pele has been recognized for having the world's largest My Little Pony collection for 6 years in a row.
He beat me!
Sit down!
Your word is funk. Funk.
Oh. Funk. F-U-N-K.
That is correct. Mr. Pele.
Calm yourself, please. Come on.
Every night, Mr. Pele sleeps with a stuffed dragon named Leonard.
Your word is numino ultra microscopic silico volcanic prognosis.
Can I have the definition?
A disease caused by inhaling volcanic ash.
Can you repeat the word?
Numino ultra microscopic silico volcanoconiosis.
I think I need to forfeit my turn.
Looking through.
excited to announce to you today the winners of the raffle baskets.
Okay.
Ready?
It's very exciting.
It is very exciting. Okay. So, the winner of the Jersey Mike's and Snacks basket is...
Mr. Kale.
That's Kale.
No, it's not. Oh, that's right. They changed it to Kale. It's Kale.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. He did say that.
Kale.
The winner.
What? Oh, go, 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 go.
The winner of the Giant Eagle $25 gift card goes to...
Bob F.
Bob F.
Bob F.
The winner of the Valentine's Day basket goes to...
Bella O'Brien.
That says Bella O'Brien.
Oh.
The winner of the Walmart gift card is...
Linda.
Linda. The winner of the Steak and Shake basket goes to...
Charlene Hall.
You got that one right? Yes. The winner of the Steel Valley gift card goes to...
Mandy Cummings.
We're getting ready. The winner of the beauty basket goes to...
Mandy. Mandy. Trehorn.
Trehorn. Trehorn. The winner of the Mocha House $20 gift card goes to...
Charlene Hall.
Yeah. The winner of the Bath and Body Works gift
Ted
card...
Ted Evans.
Why don't you just read them then, Carl?
The BJ's $25 gift card goes to...
Adriana Sky.
Yeah.
The winner of the Build-A-Bear Teddy goes to...
Mandy T.
Mandy T.
Oh. Yeah.
Now,
would you like to read this one?
Yes.
Condado's $25 gift card goes to...
Kim A.
The kid's supply basket goes to...
Maisie B.
She stop it.
And the winning number for the 50-50, make sure to check your tickets, is...
4-6.
That's 9.
That's a 6.
That's a 4-4-9-9-1-2-3. Again, 4-9-9-1-2-3. And the winning amount is $40. Make sure to collect your prizes at the table after the show. Enjoy!
Humiliating. You know what?
Into the yellow ones! Put the ones who did the peanut that can't be near them! You know what? You could have been eliminated for that if you hadn't already been disqualified!
You want to know something, Barf? I may be out, but you are the biggest loser here!
Oh, yeah? Well, that is a common misperception! Look, I know what your name was, and I do not need to take pity from someone who is named after a vegetable.
It's a fruit!
Well, it's a disgusting fruit, and I can't keep them down.
Okay, then.
I guess it's okay for a name, though.
Did you know, if you take an olive and switch the first two vowels, you get I love.
Did you know if you take William, switch the first two vowels, you get William.
But then if you switch the next two, you get Will-aim.
Are these really the kind of things that you think about?
Yeah, why?
No reason. Well, I'm more besides that myself.
But you're also a really great speller, too.
Oh, yeah? Thanks. Mm-hmm.
Olive, I love.
That's so stupid!
Ladies and gentlemen, our final spellers. Let's give them a hand. We have Homeschool from the Basin meets Homie Bear.
Mom, I'm in the finals!
Come on, Lady of Intermittent Sorrows, Miss Marcy Park.
I'm not all business.
From Cold Springs Country Day, Mr. William Barkley.
God hates losers because losers do not know how to win.
Yes, we do.
Don't get up.
pony bear.
Vulpine? V-U-L-P-I-N-E! Vulpine?
That is correct. It's Ostrovsky. Howix.
Howix?
Howix.
H-A-L-O-U-X, Howix?
Correct. Barfy.
Barfay?
Halliver.
Halliver. P-A-L-A-V-E-R. Halliver.
Correct.
I know.
It's Park. Rigaud.
R-O-O-I-B-O-S.
Right, the Schwartz Tilapia.
My real mom Joan said defiant for one. one day pay off. And also, I will grow up to be incredibly handsome.
Sure. Antihistamine.
Watch the draw. One moment, please. Antihistamine. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E, Mr. Panchy!
Punch?
Ew, buffet!
Miss Park.
Miss Park speaks five languages.
No, I don't.
Don't you?
No.
It also says that you won your school's handwriting competition.
And does it say that I only sleep 3 hours a night? And I hide in the bathroom cabinet, and I'm not allowed to cry.
Like Harry Potter.
No, it does not say that.
Well, it should. And it should say, I speak six languages.
Oh, six.
Every language easy. Easy as a recipe for making jam. I speak six languages.
For Marcy, a harder word.
Well, it was, but now that you're here, can I ask for something better?
I'm here for you now, Marcy. C'est tout point tout ici.
Jesus, what would happen if I didn't win today?
What do you think would happen?
Well, I don't know, but I guess what I'm saying is, would you be disappointed with me if I lost?
Of course not, but I also wouldn't be disappointed if you were to win.
So you're saying it's up to me then?
Yes, and also I really don't tend to care about these types of things.
Camouflage.
camouflage. C A M O U F L A J Z H. Camouflage is up. I put that word.
It means wildly fanciful, imaginary, visionary,
Mr. Barfi. Mr. Barfi. Good morning, Mr. Barfi.
Thank you, Douglas.
Your word is crepuscule.
I'm sorry,
crepuscule.
Crepuscule. One moment, please. Crepuscule. There's something sticky on the floor. I'll take it back from after the crep. You.
We need a spelling, Barfi.
Can I wash off my foot first? Could you give me the definition?
It means twilight.
Twilight. Could you use it in a sentence?
She thought she was walking into the dawn, but it turned out it was the crepuscule.
Ew. Crepuscule. C-R-E-P-U-S-T-U-L-E. Crepuscule.
That is correct.
Mom! I didn't even have to fight!
Schwartz.
I'd just like to say, Carl, that I can do this on my own.
Bug.
Bug? That's the whole word? Bug?
Bug.
Language of origin?
Cornish dialect, a Latin derivative.
Cornish! That's like English with Dutch influence. Bug. V-U-G-G-H-E, bug.
That is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-U-G, thug.
So simple?
Very simple.
I'm so sorry, Dad. I overcomplicated. I hope you still love me, America. America. I gave it my best try. If you still don't love me, America. Understand why you
to rearrange the letters of that word, you would get the phrase, Mr.
That's a problem.
Spell this next word correctly in order to take the Putnam
beat.
Are you ready, William?
Why, yes, Doug, thank you. I am ready.
Then please spell Veltenshaw.
Oh, yes, of course! Veltenshaw, meaning your personal perspective, your philosophy, the way that you look at the world.
That is correct.
I know.
on behalf of your accomplishment, William Morris Barfay, we would like to pronounce to you this $200 savings bond towards your future education.
All my life, I have only been able to breathe through one nostril. And today is no exception.
Today, there's also a runner-up prize.
There is?
Yeah. Yeah, because if the primary speller can't fulfill his duties as speller, then the runner-up has to step in. So for our 25th show, the Putnam optometrist decided to give us a $25 runner-up prize.
$25? I can't believe it! Thank you! Miss Freddy! I can pay my fee now.
Very good. Very good.
Very good.
Oh, Barf! Barf!
Yeah?
Could be.
Oh, please don't Frosty. You too.
Yeah, but I made a dumb mistake on healing glasses. Oh.
No, not really. I wasn't sure how to spell that one either.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, you're totally right. I knew how to spell that word.
Hey! Hey, Barf.
Yeah?
Congratulations!
Oh, of course!
Big high five. Come on. You're obvious.
Douglas Ponch decided to find a new meaning in life. He went by the name of Mitchell Mahoney. Now, after courting him tirelessly for over 2 years, Mitch finally filed a restraining order. But still, Ponch is excited to experience love.
Grandma Lisa Freddy left Putnam County for a stretch and traveled the world. She brought competitive spelling to the less fortunate. She hosted national bees in Latvia, Sweden, and the Republic of Guinea-Bissau, where she met an indigenous cashew farmer and became the top realtor in that country.
Mitch Mahoney discovered a new talent at the Putnam Bee, so he made his lifelong commitment service to help those kids, frustrated educators, and those boarding as well. He now puts in touch with all the people he helps while still referring streamers against the coach.
Friend, Hollabaugh. He came in 47.